Hello friends, welcome to the investment banking module of Wall Street Mojo. Today's topic is enterprise value. And friends, enterprise value is one of the most important valuation tool which helps the companies in making investment decisions. Enterprise value is a broader term than the commonly used term called as market capitalization. I'm sure you all must have heard about the term market capitalization, which is what is the current market value of the company's stock. Enterprise value is a broader term than market capitalization. Enterprise value basically identifies what is the total value of the firm. That means what is the total value or what is the total price an acquirer may be willing to pay for the said company. Let us try to go through the definition of enterprise value or firm value. Enterprise value or firm value consider much more than just value of a company's outstanding equity, which we have just now discussed, which is called as market capitalization. It tells you much more a business worth. Enterprise value is a theoretical price an acquirer might pay for another firm and is useful in comparing firms with different capital structure, since the value of firm is unaffected by its choice of capital structure. The reason why often investment bankers and acquiring companies use enterprise value as an investment tool because enterprise value does not really differentiate between the capital structure of the company. For example, if a company A has a 50-50 capital structure, that means out of its total capital, 50% is equity and 50% is debt. The value market capitalization, which is the value of the equity, will be different for company A having a 1:1 capital ratio than a company B, which has 100% equity, even though all the other parameters are same. The reason being, with company A will be considered as a financially leveraged company, and as a result of which, the market price of company A will be different than company B. We will discuss about it, and hence, enterprise value is considered, which does not really differentiate between the capital structure of the company. That means enterprise value treat all the companies as same, whether it has 100% equity or it has certain elements of debt financing into it. Let us try to understand how to compute enterprise value or what is the formula for computation of enterprise value of a company. Enterprise value of a company is market capitalization plus market value of preferred equity plus market value of debt plus minority interest minus cash and cash equivalents. So there are primarily five components which are involved in computation of enterprise value. Let us try to discuss each of these components. Let us first try to understand what does the term market capitalization means. Market capitalization is nothing but the total value of the company's outstanding equity shares or outstanding common stock of the company. If the current market price of the company's stock is $500 and the company has 1,000 common stock outstanding, in that case, market capitalization will be $500 multiplied by 1,000 common stock. This will give me the market capitalization. So market capitalization is nothing but the current market value of the company's outstanding common stock. What is market value of preferred equity? It is very similar to market capitalization. Market capitalization computes the value of the common stock of the firm, whereas market value of preferred equity computes the current market value of any preferred stock which is outstanding for the company. If the company has issued any preferred stock, we need to include the market value or the current market value of the company's preferred stock as well. What is market value of debt? as the name suggests, we also need to compute what is the current market value of the company's debt. Usually, the book value of the debt is only considered as market value of the debt. Minority interest is if a company wants to acquire the company for which we are computing the enterprise value. If there is any minority interest in that company, we need to include the minority interest as well. For example, if company A wants to acquire company B and company B has certain minority interest in his balance sheet, and in that case, we need to include that component of minority interest when we are computing the enterprise value of this company. Now, having considered all these components, we need to reduce the cash and cash equivalent which is there in the latest available balance sheet of the company, or the last available balance sheet on the date when we are computing the enterprise value. The question which comes is, why do we really need to reduce cash and cash equivalent? The reason is, sole purpose of computing enterprise value of any company is to identify how much price an acquirer needs to pay if he wants to acquire that company. And since cash and cash equivalent is a cash balance which is available with the company, if the company acquires that target company, the cash and cash equivalent will also become the acquirer's cash and cash equivalent. That's first reason. Second reason is, if the company has certain cash and cash equivalent, the company can use the said cash and cash equivalent to repay the current debt or outstanding debt of the company. And therefore, the enterprise value can come down. Therefore, we need to reduce any cash and cash equivalent which is available. Let us quickly try to compute the enterprise value of a company. I have a question over here. Current market price of the company is $1,600 per share. The number of common stocks which are outstanding is 500,000. So 500,000 common stocks are outstanding for the company. The current value of company's debt is $7 million. And the cash and cash equivalent which is available in the books of the company is $400,000. What we need to do? We need to compute the enterprise value of the company for which the given information are given. And in order to compute the enterprise value, first we need to compute the market capitalization. How much the value the company's current common stock has. So as I mentioned, the market capitalization is nothing but current market price of the company multiplied by the total number of common stocks which is outstanding. So I am multiplying $1,600 multiplied by 500,000 common stock will give me the current market capitalization of the company common stock. In this, I am going to add value of company's debt. The current value of the company's debt is already given in the problem, which is $7 million. From the market capitalization of the common stock and the value of debt, I will need to reduce the cash and cash equivalent, which is also given in the problem. The cash and cash equivalent, which is given, I need to reduce that. That means I need to reduce $400,000 in order to compute the enterprise value of the company. Enterprise value is also termed as firm value. So the market capitalization plus value of debt minus cash and cash equivalent will give me what is the current enterprise value of this particular company. That means if an acquirer wants to acquire this company, he needs to pay at least this enterprise value amount to the target company. Obviously, when an acquisition happens, it may so happen that the acquisition is happening at a value which is more than the current enterprise value because of certain additional synergies which a target, which an acquirer might get if he acquires the said target company. Let us quickly go through this chart wherein the enterprise value of Apple is given. And as you can see, the enterprise value of Apple has seen a growing trend over the last 10 years. However, over the last 2 to 3 years, the company has seen a significant decrease in the current enterprise value of the stock or current enterprise value of the company. Currently, the company's enterprise value is around $615 billion. Okay, so this is the whole concept of enterprise value.